This is the Shure SM7B microphone. And there's a couple things that maybe if you're like me, when you mount this microphone, you may want to change. Like if you want to change the XLR input from this side to this side, as well as if you are mounting this to something like a microphone stand, the logo is upside down. The logo's meant to be hung on a boom arm or something like that. If I switch this bracket to this side, then the logo will be right side up. All that in this video. So if you're looking to take the XLR and just flip it so it's on the other side. The first way I don't recommend doing because it took me too long, but if you want to try it, maybe you'll have better luck. It involved using an Allen wrench to get to the screw right on the center of this little Y bracket. I found it the most efficient to take this little foam cover off so you have a little bit more lip to access the screw. But it took me way too long to seed the Allen wrench every single time I needed to do an extra rotation to loosen that screw. And on top of that, you have to flip the XLR around and then repeat the whole process again in tightening that screw. All in all, it wasn't worth it to me doing it that Allen wrench way because I found a much faster method, and that involves taking these screws off and then you can flip this bracket so you can configure your mount however you want to. So to begin with, just loosen one end. You're gonna have this part, and then you're gonna have the three separate types of washers. The outermost washer will look like this, and it's not circular on the inside. It's actually the same shape as the screw. The next washer is this bendy kind, and then below that you have what you would normally see as a washer. This ring around the screw is the next piece that you want to remove. And I actually found it pretty easy to just pull on it and then kind of shake the microphone like this, and it pops right out. Gonna unscrew my other side. At this point, with both the tighteners gone, I can now remove the Y bracket. And just to show you, there are two more washers on each side. Here we have another round washer, and then we have a plastic kind of washer that's closest to the microphone. So if you don't remember the order, it looks like this on the screw. Obviously, I don't have the little ring here to show you, but this is what it looks like once you're gonna put it back on the screw. At this point, you can orient this however you want to. One other thing to point out is there's no logo right here as it's normally set up. So I actually wanna flip this around so you can see the Shure SM7B on the top, because I think that's kind of cool. The logo will be upwards as well when it's on a music stand. And to take things a step further, I'm going to take the XLR and flip it backwards. So to place this on, I'm going to lock that into place for the first one and put this right there. So again, I just wanna point out that it goes the plastic washer, then that metal washer, and then the bracket. This is the most important part of the whole tutorial. Once you got the bracket back on, you may have trouble with this ring, and if you don't set it up correctly, you won't be able to fasten this down all the way. I'll show you what I mean. So right here, I've put the ring back in, but I wanna make sure that I can push it all the way in so it's gonna be butting up against the microphone. Right now it's not. You have to make sure that it goes through the metal and plastic washer right there. One thing that helped me was just to get something that was a little thin so I could push these around and then push this down into place so it seeds correctly. I'll put the metal washer on first, then this wavy washer, and then the one that's not a circle on the inside. Put that little tightening screw, all of these on, and if you tighten it and you realize that it's not as tight as it used to be, that's because that metal ring on the inside isn't seated all the way to the microphones. So I gotta fix that. Put this guy back in, and now I have the tension that I'm looking for. Now I do have the XLR on the opposite side if that's something that you're looking for. And if I were to put this onto a microphone stand like this, the Shure logo is right side up. And not only that, but on this side, the Shure logo is facing upwards as well. Pretty cool. If this video was helpful, don't forget to leave a thumbs up. If you like my kind of content, I encourage you to check out more of my videos. Right here is something recommended just for you by the robots that are taking our jobs. And this was my most recent video. All right, until next time, I hope you're out there living a life of abundance. Bye.